Assalamu alaikum everyone. Today our topic is astrology of large sign. So objectives are should know basic astrology of wall of gut and astrology of large sign, appendix and anal canal. The large intestine, it is comprises of cecum, colon, rectum and anal canal. Here you can see this is the cecum, the first descended part of large intestine, cecum, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmoid colon, rectum and the anal canal. So these are the parts of large intestine. What is the function of large intestine? Its function is absorption of water and salt and formation of fecal mass. Another function is production of mucus. Here is the micrograph which is taken from your Beter's book of anatomy at the ileocecal junction. Here at the level of ileocecal junction, here you can see there's an abrupt transition of lining of valve from small intestine as indicated by S. Small intestine villi form pattern, is the villus form pattern, S to the glandular form pattern, L. This is the large intestine as indicated by L, large intestine. Here you can note no villi in case of large intestine. And here is the ileum, ileo as name indicated, ileocecal valve. So here is the transition of lining of from small intestine. There's a villus pattern of mucosal epithelium. And here you can see the change of villus pattern to the glandular form. Here you can note there is no villi. So what is the ileocecal valve? It is consist of extension, thicken, extension of muscularis mucosae. Here, here is the muscularis mucosae and here is the lamina propria. Here is the lining epithelium. So it is extension of muscularis mucosae into the lamina propria, which provide robust support to the mucosa. You can see here the lymphoid tissue as indicated as LY, lymphoid tissue in the mucosa. So before we are going to discuss the wall of large intestine, you should know about the basic layers of wall of gut as we previously did. So basic layer of wall of gut from inward to outward are the mucosa. Mucosa have an epithelium. Next to epithelium is the lamina propria and here is the muscularis mucosae. So this is the parts of mucosa: epithelium, lamina propria and muscularis mucosae. Next layer is the submucosa. Submucosa contain the loose adherent tissue in addition to blood vessels and also contain the glands. That is the submucosal glands. And the next third layer is the after submucosa is the muscularis externa, which comprises of two layers, circular muscle layer and longitudinal muscle. Here is the circular muscle layer and this is the longitudinal layer with the exception of the stomach, which has three layers. One is oblique, then circular and outer longitudinal. So arrangement of muscular externa is same all over the wall of gut throughout the GIT. So here you can note the submucosal plexus that is present between the circular layer and the submucosa, and next layer next plexus is that is the mantle plexus that is present between the longitudinal and circular muscle layer, and the fourth layer of wall of gut is the serosa, which consists of inner connective tissue layer and outer peritoneal layer, that is the visceral layer or mesothelium. Come to the large intestine histological layers. You can see here mucosa which is comprises of lamina propria. Here is the intestinal glands, and this is the muscularis mucosae. Here is the submucosa, which contain loose alveolar tissue. In addition to blood vessels, there is a lymphatic nodule. The third layer is the muscularis externa, which is comprises of inner circular and outer longitudinal layer. And fourth layer is the serosa. The histological structure of large intestine, it is considered details are mucosa. What type of epithelium does it contain? It contains the simple columnar ciliated epithelium, which is folded and form straight glands or crypts of lubricants. So epithelial cells formed of two types. One is mucus type cells, these are called as a goblet cells, and other cells are the Bruch cells. These are actually absorbing cells for absorption of salt and water. The mucus cell increases and the Bruch cells decreases towards the anal canal. This is why, because as there is a absorption of salt and water at the fecal material or feces passes along the wall of lumen of large intestine, there's absorption of water and other contents like salt. So it becomes dehydrated and becomes hard material. So it can damage the mucosa of the large intestine. So that is why number of mucus cells increases as we go down towards the anal canal. For the they provide the secretion for lubrication of feces, so it can easily be passed through the anal canal without any damage to mucosa. That is why number of goblet cells or mucus cells increases as we go down to the anal canal. Here you can see large intestine epithelium. Here is no villi are there. As compared with the large intestine, if we compare the histological epithelium of small intestine and large intestine, here are the straight tubular glands or crypts. Here's the lumen of crypts, you can see here. And these are the goblet cells. Look at the cursor, goblet cells. And between goblet cells, these are the absorbing cells, are the Bruch cells. So this is the luminal surface of these tubular glands, and here is the basal surface. Towards the basal surface, the number of goblet cells are more, and towards the luminal surface, you can see the Bruch cells or absorbing cells are more. So in addition to these two types of epithelial cells, you can also see here there are other number of cells which are present in these glands. These cells are called stem cells. They are continually dividing and converting into the epithelium, and other cells are endocrine cells. So next layer after mucosa, the next layer of mucosa is the lamina propria. It is formed of collagen fibers, which is rich in blood vessels and Peyer's patches. The muscularis mucosa, it is formed of sheet of smooth muscle. Its function is to conduction of glandular secretion. So here you can see These are the surface epithelium with goblet cells. Here's the absorbing cells, goblet cells. Here in between them, this is the lamina propria. You can see here, Krebs of lubricants, straight tubular glands. This is the lamina propria. Here you can see the muscularis mucosae. What was the function of muscularis mucosae? It help in conduction of glandular activity or secretion. So again, muscularis externa. Musculus externa, it is formed of two layers. And submucosa, which contain areolar tissue. Here in this diagram, which is taken from your Vieter's book of histology, here's the mucosa. Here is the submucosa, which is formed of loose areolar tissue, blood vessels, nerves, and lymphatics. In addition to that, it contains lymphoid tissue or lymphoid aggregates, which are present in the submucosa as well as in the lamina propria of the mucosa. Here, third layer is the muscularis externa, which is consists of inner circular layer and outer longitudinal layer. So here you can see this diagram. This is a straight tubular glands, which contain closely packed cells, that is your epithelial cells, goblet cells, and mucus secreting cells, and absorbing cells are brush cells. Here is the transverse section, which is taken at this level. In transverse section, you can see lumen of the gland, and these are the arrangement of goblet cells as well as the absorbing cells. Here's the lamina propria. So, what is the how will you differentiate between the goblet cell and absorbing cells? This micrograph is taken on high magnification power. You can differentiate as goblet cells have a condensed nuclei which is present towards the basal surface, while the absorbing cells are the Burat cells. They have a large nuclei, oval large nuclei, which is present in the center of the cell. These are also called enterocytes. So again, you can see there is a arrangement of longitudinal muscle collected into bands called tenia coli. These are the distinct band of smooth muscle that run longitudinally. They converge at the appendix. There are three types of these coli: mesocolic tenia, omental tenia, and free tenia. Mesocolic tenia gives attachment to mesentery of transverse and sigmoid mesocolon, and omental tenia, in which the omental appendix is attached. Free tenia can be followed on the surface of the colon. So these tenia altogether, they contract lengthwise to form the hystra. Here's the hystra formation. As these longitudinal muscle contract altogether, they will form the hystra. Secular bags like structures. Now the histology of appendix: star-shaped lumen, mucosa. It contains mucosa, submucosa, musculus externa, and serosa. As in mucosa, it contains simple corneal epithelium with many goblet cells. Here is the mucosa of the appendix. Here it contains the intestinal glands. Here you can see intestinal glands. Here is the lining epithelium, which comprises of simple columnar epithelium along with the goblet cells. Here is the lamina propria. All around, here is the lamina propria. And lamina propria also contain aggregates of lymphoid tissue. Over here, aggregates of lymphoid tissue. Then after lamina propria, you can see mark here a layer of smooth muscle. This is called as the muscularis mucosae, that is present all around. Look at the cursor. Next to muscularis mucosae, you can mark here the submucosa, which contains loose areolar tissue. It contains also number of blood vessels, lymphatic vessels and nerves. Next to this layer of mucosa is the muscularis externa. You can easily mark here the inner circular and outer longitudinal layer. And after that is the serosa layer. Serosa, it contains the serosa. So another is the part is the anal canal. It is the lower part of large intestine. Its function is to provide passage for the feces outside the body. The mucosa of the upper part of anal canal lined by simple columnar, while the middle part lined by stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium and its lower part lined by skin. So mucosal fold and formed the anal columns. Here you can note, here's the mucosa of the anal canal. Here mucosa folded to form the anal columns. Here's the pectinate line. And here's the anal valves. So lamina propria, it is formed of collagen which support the mucosa. It can also contain, lamina propria also contains the blood vessels. So submucosa, it is also comprises as in a whole GIT, it is comprised of loose connective tissue, nerves, blood vessels and lymphatics. So musculosa or musculus externa, it is formed of inner circular and outer longitudinal layer, and there is a skeletal muscle cover the outer longitudinal layer also. So serosa, it is formed of connective tissue to support the anal canal with the surrounded tissue. Here you can see in this diagram, look at the cursor, this is the mucosa, here is the submucosa. And next to submucosa, here is the muscular layer, inner circular, outer longitudinal. Here is the levator ani muscles. Here is the external anal sphincter. It will form the internal anal sphincters. So thank you all. This was all about the histology of large intestine.